This is gonna be weirder than usual. Can't be helped. You called me. So here I am. I know I shut you out sometimes. I'm always glad to hear from you. It's just that I get my hopes up. So many times it's led to nothing. I found nothing. It's like we live in a room, and there's a poster on the wall. We stare at it and we think that's the whole world. The room and the poster. The picture's something nice. A landscape, a famous person. Like in that movie, what is it called? The prison movie. The room's a cell, and the picture, it's different for each of us. It can be beautiful or terrible, but we're all transfixed. But it's all a lie. Something to distract us from the truth. They're lying to us. We're lying to ourselves. The room's not the world. The world is much bigger and much stranger. There's a hole hidden behind that poster that leads to the real world. We all feel safe in that room. But sometimes something crawls out from behind the poster. And the ones that see it happen freak out and try to forget what they saw. I'm here. Why did you bring me here?
Hello? Anyone here?
I saw it a long time ago. I keep seeing it in my dreams. Federal Bureau of Control. All these years, I've been looking for them, and they were hiding in plain sight.
About the job. Janitor's assistant. You need to go to the interview. Go that way to the elevator.
Thanks. Elevator that way. Got it.
Very good. I'm Ahti, the janitor, by the way. You'll work for me. You can say I sent you. If they don't hire you, you are no hell of it. There be work for the axe. Take them behind the sauna, you mallard.
I've done enough night shift loner jobs to know it makes us come off weird. Ahti the janitor is a friendly face in my book.
Better than somebody with no face at all. Think about it. No face.
The cell. And the poster. I was 11 years old the first time I saw behind the poster. They told me I imagined it. I've been trying to pull it down ever since. Will you help? Did I lose you there for a moment? You know what's on my mind. My baby brother, Dylan. 17 years since the men of this bureau took him.
Thank you.
the poster.
Objects of power can cause or be results of AWE's altered world events, intrusions upon the perceived reality. Now, the service weapon is, of course, a prime example of an OOP, a very powerful one, ingrained in the Bureau's DNA, a key component in our prime candidate program. Come out of that Russian roulette a winner, and you, you're it.
Look at this place. Where am I? The same gun. Okay, now I have a gun. Hear that? It's the dead man. Right after the pyramid spoke to me, and it was just noise, and I understood every word. And this gun's alive. You know what? I'm happy. Happy to be here. Things have quieted down outside. Is it safe to go?
You can't let this happen! You can't let this happen! You can't let this happen!
You stopped it. You... Oh, thank you. That was... horror.
Okay.
Sound that tried to invade me earlier. The hiss burrowing into everything in this place. Is the hiss your enemy? All right, it's our enemy. That babble's contagious. It burrows in like an infuriating melody that makes you hum it over and over. Cleanse the control point. What does that mean? Help me fix it.
Oh.
We did it.
Hello? Can you hear me? Are you with us? With the Bureau? Are you still sane?
I can't tell you how happy I am to talk to somebody sane.
The feeling's mutual. I'm Pope, Emily Pope, Dr. Darling's assistant.
My turn. Should I lie?
Jesse Faden. I'm just visiting.
I should have lied.
Oh, shit! You're the new director! Hold on! We're coming out!
Director, Faden.
Call me Jesse.
Okay, Jesse. I'm Emily. Look, somehow, this hostile force, this...
Hiss?
That works. Somehow the Hiss managed to infiltrate the building without any warning.
And just like that, my name for it is official. The Hiss. Like the sound of poison gas leaking in.
We're in full lockdown. It seems to have spread everywhere and to everyone not protected by an HRA. And, extraordinarily, you. You are the director, and that makes you special by definition. Trench is no longer the director, obviously. I'm sorry, I'm talking too much. This whole situation is just a lot.
Trench is dead. Shot.
Ah.
I found his body. And the gun.
Do I tell her it looked like a suicide?
The service weapon.
Also, and this can sound crazy, but he keeps appearing to me, saying things. It's hard to make out, but he told me to cleanse the control point, push the Hiss out. The whole room shifted around.
You did that? And you entered the building when it was already in the lockdown, before you became the new director? How?
I'm not ready to tell her about you yet.
A janitor let me in.
I love it. This is fucking unbelievable. I can't even... Look, Jesse, I have a million questions, and you probably have a million more.
Like, do you know my brother Dylan? Not yet.
But there's something I need to ask you to do first. If you can cleanse a control point, then you can maybe cure those infected or possessed by the Hiss. Because if that's possible, our options are very different.
Emily Pope. I don't know her, but I like her already. She's the opposite of the faceless agency I've blamed for what happened to me for so long. But I can't trust her yet. Or rather, the Bureau she's a part of.
Yes. I can try.
I'm speaking for you, of course. We can try it together. Okay. You with me? We did it before. Push the Hiss out.
Has burrowed too deep. Ripping it out rips them apart.
We need to make a plan, Jesse.
I can't cleanse them.
I saw. It was worth a shot. Thank you, Director. Jesse.
I'm gonna tell her why I'm here. I'll risk it.
Listen. The Bureau was involved in an incident in my hometown, Ordinary, 17 years ago. The Bureau came in and covered the whole thing up. I've been looking for this place for a long time.
That's enough. Maybe that's too much already. I can't tell her about Dylan and the rest yet.
I've seen mentions of an altered world event case dealing with Ordinary. You were at Ground Zero as a child? It was one of the big ones, and before my time. And very classified. I can try to dig out some old files for you. My boss, Casper Darling, would know, but he's missing. I think he knew this was coming, or suspected. He came up with the HRAs, the Hadron Resonance Amplifiers. I think they're what saved us. A few of us. And Director Trench would know.
Trench? The ghost, or whatever he is. He mentioned something called the hotline. Said I should find it.
It's another object of power, like the gun. An old Bakelite telephone. A direct line of communication between the Director and the board. Maybe he can talk to you more clearly through that. I mean, Trench has years and years of experience. He might know how to destroy the hiss.
Where is the hotline?
It's kept in the communications department through the mailroom. It's part of this sector, so we can access it even with the lockdown in place. We'll get the door open for you.
Okay. That's my next stop.
That's Tomasi's department. He's head of communications. I don't think he had an HRA. He kind of made a point about not wearing one earlier. Keep an eye out.
They call me the Director. But that's not me. I'm not a director type. Not a leader.
Why am I here? I think you already know. Yes, I came for my brother, but there are other reasons too. I said I was looking for answers, but I might never understand them. I'm not looking for proof. This is already it. More than enough. No matter what they told me all those years, I know it's real now. I didn't imagine this. I want to be a part of this world. What scares me shitless is that I finally found it. Only to see the hiss destroy it all.
So, don't hesitate to ask me anything you want to know. There are no stupid questions. The door to the comms department is just outside the boardroom back in the lobby. They should have gotten it open by now. Follow the signs to the mailroom. You can get to the hotline containment chamber through there. Good luck, Jesse. See you back here once you have the hotline.
Thanks, Emily.
There it is again. Our welcome message. Overpowering here. You don't want me anywhere near it. With you on that.
Thank you.
inches wide and capable of storing a whopping 80 kilobytes. Stolen by our friends at the CIA, the disk held the launch codes to Soviet nukes. This is not the disk, of course, but one exactly like it, a perfect fusion of concepts vibrating in the Cold War era collective unconscious. A receptacle. It is a receptacle for dangerous energies to hone in on, and they did. We don't have the details, but when things started flying around the disk, it was transferred to us. It's an object of power. OOP. Oops. Oh, and it can launch things telekinetically through the air. To date, we've launched maybe 3 dozen pencils. And once, we even launched a cup.
Communications. We're on the right track.
Thank you.
Object of power. But the Hiss have latched onto it. We need to cleanse it. Harder to hear you when I'm here. It's like the channel's been changed. The boards in charge here, their pyramids and bureau seal. Are they really the ones pulling the strings? I'm not their director. I'm no one's director. You were gone. Cut off. I got it. Just like you wanted, right? This will help me fight the Hiss. Emily said that the hotline can be reached through the mailroom. This must open the door.
listening to America Overnight, mystifying the airwaves for more than 29 years. Thank you for staying up with us. Ghosts. We've had many callers over the years tell us of hauntings, voices, and other phantasmagorical phenomena. Today, friend of the show, Dr. Quincy Reagan, tells his story. Quincy.
Thanks. This is something I experienced recently while staying at the Chili Pines Motel in Macon for last year's Suspicion Con. I was in room 47. Night manager, an avid listener of the program, insisted I take this particular room. Now, the manager explained that years back, the body of a man was discovered under the bed. Inside the room border that they were termites in the guests had stayed there, sleeping with the corpses.
Great.
not still focused. The hotline should be past the map. Alberto Tomasi, head of comms. Just got him.
All right, take this down. The situation in Cuba has been evaluated by the relevant authorities. The mysterious illness affecting the staff at the U.S. Embassy in Havana was caused by sonic weaponry in the hands of a foreign power. Numerous personnel have damage to the inner ear, but most are expected to make a full recovery. Of course, the event also damaged their cellular walls, but we can't blame that on some stupid noise gun. Thank God no local doctors examined them first. Honestly, what are the odds an alternate and we show up inside the U.S. Embassy? Talk about good luck, huh? So much easier to... Are you still recording this?
The hotline can't be far now. Been here before? No. I've stayed at a lot of roadside motels across the country, on the road, on the run, under the radar. This feels like all of them, like something recognized from a dream.
Anyone here?